space suit, man. Well, isn't Jesus coming again? And the Bible says, the dead in Christ shall rise first, and those that remain shall come to lead them to where? Oh, thank you. Wow. You're great. Mm-hmm. This is great. See, we have this now. Get in her room, I gotta try that. Oh. Wow. What a combination. Mm-hmm.
Well, then, it's a better price than my first. Yes?
Well, I just want to be ready for takeoff when Jesus comes.
Well, I'm sure Jesus is going to get all of our spacesuits ready. Listen, Joshua, how are we doing this good morning?
Well, Kirkland, it's a beautiful day in the neighborhood.
Sounds like I've heard that reading somewhere before. Listen, I missed your last Sabbath. Where were you?
Well, I'm waiting for an answer. Well, if you must know, I went to go see that new cartoon movie that just came out, The Land Before Time, Part 26. Littlefoot goes to school.
Wait a minute. You went to the movies on the Sabbath?
Shh, not so loud. Someone might hear you.
That's the last thing you need to worry about.
True.
What's gotten into you? Oh, what's the big deal? Church is a drag sometimes.
Excuse me?
They do the same thing every week. Sing, pray, and preach. And anyway, the church is full of hippopotamuses.
Hippo what?
You know, people who say one thing and do another. You mean hypocrites. That's what I say.
You really need to quit making excuses.
You're not going to start lecturing like my grandma, are you? I mean, the next thing you know, you're going to be telling me I need to go to bed early and eat a healthy breakfast.
Listen, Joshua, I'm sure your grandma cares a lot about you. I care about you, just like God does.
Think about what you've done. Missing church for a week is no big deal.
No big deal? There was a time you would have never considered doing anything like going to the movies on the Sabbath. When you start making excuses for missing church on the Sabbath, it just opens the door to make excuses to miss another and another
and another.
And besides, God's word says in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 25, let us not neglect the meeting of ourselves together, as some people do, but let us encourage and warn one another, especially now, since the day that is coming back is drawing near.
Can I get religion at home?
Joshua, going to church has never been about getting religion. It's about obedience. Going to church is not simply a matter of form, but it's consecrated service to God. It is also a time for expression of thanksgiving, a time to relate our daily experiences, and for divine enlightenment that we might know God and Jesus Christ, whom He has sent.
Yeah. Wow, you make church sound like a great experience.
It's the best.
But the church I go to is small. The air conditioning doesn't work, and they don't serve the kind of lunches I like.
Are you still making excuses? Let me quote my favorite Christian author, Ellen White, on this very same subject. She states, the place of worship may be very humble, but is no less acknowledged by God. To those who worship God in spirit and in truth and in the beauty of holiness, it'll be as the gates of heaven.
You mean going to church can actually feel like going to the gates of heaven?
With the right attitude.
I guess no excuse is a good excuse for not going to church on God's holy day, the Sabbath.
That's right. When we stop making excuses for obeying God, God has no excuse not to bless us.
Can't hear it. Can't hear it. Sabbath, man. Thank you, Pastor. You don't give up, sure.
Come on, give me one more time. Put you in the bag now.
Oh, I'm waiting for the song.
Well, I think my hand will do that.
Sabbath after Sabbath. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.